Hey, Mystic Michaela Spiritual Family. Welcome to Know Your Aura with Mystic Michaela. Today, we are diving even deeper into supernatural phenomena, and we're centering it also around aura colors, how different aura colors receive paranormal experiences, filter through them. Are different aura colors more susceptible to them than others? We're going to talk about all that, including your stories. But first, hey, Scotty.
Hey, guys. Well, it's really interesting because normally I'm not into this stuff. This is not like stuff that, you know, I get excited about. I really don't care too much about it.
Right.
But, you know, and last week we did the Mothman and all that. And ever since then, I've been kind of really into it, like obsessing over this stuff.
We've been watching shows.
Right.
We've been really excited about it. It's really fascinating.
Yeah. And I mean, I'm just, my biggest thing on my, I don't know, vision boards are out now, right? My my manifestation board is I want to go to Point Pleasant, Virginia.
I know.
West Virginia, sorry. And go to the Mothman Festival.
But I know.
Anyway, the one thing we got a lot this week was people who live in West Virginia or who visited West Virginia and weird experiences. Now, you said on the podcast last episode, that anytime you go to West Virginia, you feel we don't belong there, icky feelings or whatever it is. And we've had so many responses to validate what you were talking about. So I wanted you to read one of these that we got an email that I thought was really interesting.
Yeah. All right. So this is the email we got. I have no idea if this will get through to anyone necessarily. Well, it did.
It did.
But I felt this need to reach out. This is from Shelby. All right. So Shelby writes, she wanted to give feedback about the episode since it really hit home quite literally. She says, I moved to West Virginia about a year and a half ago and have 10,000% felt this weird West Virginia vibe since moving here from New York City and have had some pretty awful unforeseen life events that I wouldn't wish on anyone. It's been a whirlwind of an experience, and I'd love to just talk about some of the strange that I've learned since moving here. To give more context, I currently live in what's known as the United States National Quiet Zone. I had no idea what that is. Where there is no Wi-Fi available, which is super true. Every time we get the parts we stayed in West Virginia, no Wi-Fi. I didn't even bring that up.
Yeah, but there's actually, I looked this up.
Oh, tell
us. She wrote it, and there's this designated area. I forgot the name. She mentions the name of the town in the email where there's no radioactivity, nothing. Like, in some cases, they can't even use like a microwave.
Wow.
And things like that. Yeah, it's really kind of creepy in a way. But also, some people go there to get away from all like the electromagnetic energy.
I'm like, let's go. I want to go there.
You want to go there, yeah.
Yeah. I'm completely off the radar and don't exist, which is completely wild for a girl that has lived in many states, New York and Texas included. The National Quiet Zone has no cell towers. And in certain places, people are not allowed to use microwaves, Wi-Fi, or Bluetooth. In the past, this particular location, Green Bay, West Virginia, about 20 miles from where I live currently, was federally regulated to control any sort of disruptions to the multiple massive satellites located in this very tiny town. What is the purpose of these satellites? To listen for aliens. I'm not kidding. This was a government-regulated site for decades and was only recently purchased by a private company to continue searching for alien contact. Aside from this very odd situation, something that has often been spoken about from the locals is the darkness that hovers over this area. It's something I felt the minute I moved here and consistently feel in my day to day. It's a very heavy energy and does feel dark and unwelcoming. The minute we leave the area, even when we're just driving in the car, leaving the county, I feel a massive weight lifted and like I can breathe again. I wouldn't call myself the most susceptible to energies, but it's something that I've been attempting to perfect for years. So this energy has been a truly daunting experience and has convinced myself and my partner to eventually move.
Yeah.
How crazy is that?
That's crazy.
We got a lot of feedback from West Virginia people saying they understand. There's certain places, even the locals don't feel great. And people who live around the TNT area, which we talked about last week, were like, yeah, there's some sort of vibe. And then I did get one DM from somebody saying, it's just the locals don't want you here. So their take on it is like, you know, we don't really like outsiders.
Okay.
So I thought that was interesting.
I mean, that's
too
possible.
Yeah.
It is interesting that she said once she leaves the area, then that cloud, that darkness lifts and it's not as heavy anymore. And that's the same thing that happens to you and Bree.
And we didn't even talk about it with Bree before we went, and she was feeling it. And like, I've visited a lot of places and it's different there.
Yeah.
For whatever reason, it feels different there.
The other thing, and they did designate the area. I forgot the name of the town that she mentioned. I did look it up. And with this no radio frequencies going through there. But there was also a lot of government installations around there.
Interesting.
So again, I always come back to this, the skepticism that I have, right? Being a Red. And I always think that, well, maybe all these things that are going on are just like these government secrets in that area. Maybe there's a lot of government undercover activity.
Sure.
I don't know. That's my take on it. I mean, there's definitely something going on.
Like,
there.
There's a vibe. There's you're a vibe. Just saying, like, maybe it's a man-made vibe. Yeah. Maybe it's a vibe from something created by the government or whatever.
Yeah. Now, last week I also mentioned that I didn't really believe John Keel.
Right.
And we looked into his colors, and he was green and purple.
Right.
And, you know, just looking at him, he gave some vibes of being a showman. And I wanted to then look into aura colors and how different aura colors respond to paranormal activity and behaviors and entities and things of that nature. And to see, you know, I'm kind of getting a little green here, to see if there's some sort of pattern, you know, the way that purples view the paranormal, or yellows, greens, reds, etc. So, of course, I can't do that on my own. I need you to do that. So I wanted to go through the different colors and see if we could figure out eventually through this episode if there's going to be a pattern. So let's start with yellow.
Before we talk about auras and the paranormal, a little word from our sponsor, Pros. You know, there's no one-size-fits-all solution when it comes to hair care. A product that works wonders for curls might make straight hair limp and greasy. I have actually naturally curly hair, and when I don't feel like straightening it, what do I do with all these curls? Well, thanks to my personalized Pros routine, I can honestly say I've never been more in love with my natural hair. Pros makes custom hair care that's effective because it's personal. Using natural ingredients with proven results, Pros customizes every product in your routine from shampoo to supplements. First, Pros starts by asking you as an actual person with their in-depth consultation. Pros asked me really unexpected things like my zip code and what my eating habits were. Next, Pros analyzed all my answers and determined what unique blends of ingredients should be in every product of my custom routine. Together, Pros got all my hair goals covered. They gave me this amazing curl cream, and I'll tell you, when I use it, and I don't want to, you know, straighten my hair, I just want it to be natural, I just put it on and let it naturally dry, and my curls look really defined and neat and tidy. Next is a carbon neutral certified B Corp. Pros is an industry leader in clean and responsible beauty. All their ingredients are sustainably sourced, ethically gathered, and cruelty-free. They're also the first custom beauty brand to go carbon neutral. If you're not 100% positive, Pros is the best hair care you've ever had. They will take the products back, no questions asked. Pros is the healthy hair regimen with your name all over it. Take your free in-depth hair consultation and get 15% off your first order today. Go to pros.com/aura. That's pros, PROSE.com/aura for your free in-depth hair consultation and 15% off. Now let's get back to it. All right. So the thing with aura colors, and if you've listened to all my episodes, they're filters. They're filters on you. And we all live in the same world. We have different filters that affect how we see it. And aura colors are one of those filters. So when I'm thinking about paranormal, this is anything from like aliens, UFO, ghosts, unexplained phenomena, anything. This is how I'm seeing the different aura colors take it in and respond to it and connect to it. So with yellow auras, this is what I've noticed. Yellow auras, obviously they love details. And I've noticed with the yellow auras, they really have this intrinsic want to understand the message and the reason. What's the connection? They make a connection with whatever this phenomena is by getting more about the narrative. So the history of what happened there. For yellow auras, when they go into something, all the possibilities are open. They're very inquisitive into what went on in this location or the space or the situation and what the need and reason for any connection are. They're really into relationships. So let's say you're a yellow aura and you live in a haunted house. Immediately, the yellow aura is on their way to the library. They're looking up the property. They're looking up, like, they're going deep in it. They're going on ancestry.com. They're like, let's figure this out. Because they want to know what the purpose is and what the overall function is. Because with yellow auras, there's always a reason. So what's the reason? And usually with them, it's some sort of interconnected relationship thing.
And are yellows, are they believe when they're doing all this work, like going to the library and finding the deed to the home and all mm-hmm. that, are they believers or are they just trying to disprove it or make it logical?
Yellows have an amazing ability to be neutral.
Okay.
They have an amazing ability to be neutral. That's why you often see yellow auras working for, you know, very difficult people or able to manage huge companies or able to deal in crazy crisis with lots of different emotions going on. Yellow aura people, like, they're the ones that get called, hey, a family's falling apart. Come help us. I'm here. Here I am. And they can hear things and they can see people explode and they can stay very neutral. So just taking that over to the paranormal side of things, they can stay neutral. Like you said, this happened. Well, let's look into it. I mm-hmm. felt this. Let me see what that could possibly mean. So they're good level-headed natures and they want proof. But they don't come in with either a skepticism, and they don't come in with a total believer.
Okay.
It's very neutral, which is good. It's good.
All right. Let's move on to purples.
So with purple auras, this is funny. This just makes me laugh. Because purple auras, they feel something. They're like, no, not right. And that's it. Done. I don't care if you believe me or not. I know there's something going on here. That's just how purple people are. They're like that with when they meet the wrong people. They're like that when they walk into a restaurant. Purples intrinsically don't really question themselves. And it's so normal to them to count on their intuition as proof that if they have an intuitive sense of something's off, they believe themselves. They don't need proof. It's interesting to get proof, but they don't really need it because their own intuition is proof enough for them, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
It's like their instinct.
Are they more open to seeing the Mothman than a yellow?
Yeah, purples and when I see purple kids, all kids are susceptible and open to things, but especially purple kids, they're more attracted to paranormal entities or people who've passed or people who've crossed over. Like, you're just more of an open door when you're purple because your intuition is something that you rely on more than your eyes or ears or what people tell you or anything like that. So yeah, you're kind of a more attractive entity for other entities, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Let's move on to the greens.
Okay. Green people. When greens feel like something's off, which they would never say, I emotionally feel something's off or my intuition says something off. They'd never say it that way. They'd just be like, this doesn't make sense. Or they'd see some sort of anomaly or they'd be like, hey, wait a second. They immediately need to back it up with scientific proof. They jump right to that. So they get the tech to back up whatever this phenomena is. They want something on paper and they can get really excited about what the tech shows them. So when you think about, UFOs or when you think about ghost hunting or things like that, that's when they get in their little tools and their interesting tech. Cause they're like, oh, look, this is a normal read of this, whatever this is. And now when it's here, it's spiking and that's proof to me. So it's like their intuition translates into science.
Okay.
And they want research-based proof, with variables and all that kind of stuff. They want to create a whole experiment around it, but it's really because that's their way of connecting to whatever it is.
Okay.
And through science. So
yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Yeah. So actually the other night in the Wednesday night discussion group that we have led by Shenya, mm-hmm. A lot of greens in there.
Yeah.
And we were talking about the episode, the Mothman, the UFOs, the Men in Black, and a lot of them recommended me this show called Skinwalker Ranch.
Oh my God.
Okay. So we didn't have time to watch, I think it's 3 seasons, 10 episodes.
Yeah.
All 30 episodes. But we did watch, it was like a recap episode and a couple episodes here and there to get kind of the feel of it.
Yeah.
And, it was totally green. It's a bunch of green guys.
Well, explain what Skinwalker Ranch is.
Yeah. Okay. So Skinwalker Ranch is this place in Utah where all this strange phenomenon happens. There's supposedly a wolf-like demonic man that haunts the region, this little area. I don't think they have ever caught this person. It dates back to
They've all seen it,
but no one's ever caught footage.
It's at the Miami Zoo.
Yeah. I mean, they had like set a trap.
Right. That would make some news, I think.
Right. You know, but,
we caught the skinwalker.
Yeah, right. And supposedly it is, the land is cursed.
Yeah.
From the tribes that live there.
They always bring up, you know, that's like a Point Pleasant thing too.
Yeah. But I mean, I've never seen a more bunch of green guys go at this thing. You know, they're shooting off their rockets. They got all their radio frequencies to try to figure out what's going on and all their equipment and their GPS trackers and all this fancy stuff. You know, if I'll admit, if I watched that show, I would have been bored to death if I actually watched every single episode.
Yeah.
I'm glad they had like a couple recap episodes.
Yeah.
Because I would have been bored with it. But what it did lead me to believe was that there's actually something going on there.
There's something going on there.
I don't know that I believe that it's a skinwalker, like a demonic wolf-like man creature, but there's definitely some sort of weird energy going on there. That's what I took from it.
It was interesting.
Yeah, because it was green.
It was interesting. There were a lot of parallels between what they're seeing at that ranch and what was going on in John Keel's accounts in Point Pleasant before the bridge collapse, because they're seeing like this tall man-like figure, which is what the Mothman was. They're seeing that people are getting headaches.
Yeah.
They're getting sick. And like, this is all caught on camera over on the Skinwalker Ranch thing. So a lot of
animals found slaughtered.
Oh, there's mutilated animals, situations, radiation spikes, which I don't think that was
also in Keel's book too. Yeah.
Okay. Cause in Skinwalker Ranch, like, it's very interesting because there is some scientific phenomena. I mean, they're seeing like orbs of light that caught on camera, like just really crazy. Actually, I do recommend the show. That recap episode is really interesting. It's interesting. So I think it leads you to believe they think it's a portal.
Yeah, that's what they concluded.
Yeah, which is what
something like that.
But I thought like the Point Pleasant thing was a portal too.
Right.
So, I mean, there's just so much stuff going on. But yeah, so because they're green auras, they have to go in there and listen, we feel something's off. We know something's off. We see something happening. Let's get it on paper. Let's get it recorded.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, and it was interesting because, again, they made me a believer, but not in the Skinwalker.
Yeah.
They made me, because I don't believe in that, but they made me a believer that there's some sort of phenomenon going on there. I don't know what it is, though, because, well, first of all, they couldn't explain it themselves. There's a lot of like energy balls that they were seeing and stuff like that, but there's definitely something.
Yeah.
But using their green technology, I actually believe
you have to believe
you
it
have to. You
because
see it. Yeah.
their phones are going crazy.
Right.
Like there's just really, and there's even more stuff going on. It's actually kind of, what's interesting is though, the energy feels intelligent.
Yeah.
So when we talk about other types of natural phenomena, cause you were talking about like, well, maybe it's just a natural phenomenon we haven't been able to name yet, but the energy itself feels a bit intelligent. Like it targets people or it was targeting certain animals and things like that. But anyways, so yeah, green people need research.
All right. What about the blues?
So blue people, they're going to end up feeling the physical effects of whatever's around. Just like blue people in their regular life, they tend to pick up energy, internalize it, and then get sick if they don't talk about it. So with paranormal, I always get nervous for blue people because they'll get like the headaches, the sickness, the feelings of overwhelm. It'll affect them physically. I worry about blue people usually in these higher energy places, like living in them or staying in them too long, because these are the ones who are going to channel it and get sick. Even if that's not the energy's intention, those blue people are the ones that can get really ill. So, I mean, I've heard lots of different paranormal experiences. Okay. And sometimes, and I don't want to freak people out, sometimes people develop really bad illnesses if they stay too long around paranormal activity. And blue people are the ones that I feel like are more susceptible to that, because it might not be the energy's intention to make you sick. It's just, that's how blue people filter it and keep it in them and express it. So they can get ill.
Yeah. I mean, when I was just going back to that show for a second, they were dealing with so much radioactive, you know, I don't know, what do you call it? Energy.
Yeah, they were getting like energy spikes, radioactive spikes, like really weird stuff.
Right. So, I mean, I felt bad.
Gamma
are
rays.
10 years, are they going to just all like drop over? And it was interesting also because in the Mothman book, they were saying that a lot of people that had seen the Mothman or were involved died, you know, a few years after.
Yeah.
Maybe the radiation. I don't know.
It could be something about making contact with these creatures that you're not, if that's what's going on.
Right.
Or this energy, you can call it if you don't want to call it a creature, these energies, it's causing...
Yeah, but even if it is radiation, I assume in high doses, then more than normal, it's going to impact your health.
Well, you're blue. And remember back to the Riddle House.
Oh, my gosh.
You got really sick.
Yeah.
And you were sick for a few days after that.
Yes.
And you won't go back to that house.
I will never go back to that
and
house.
And I didn't get that, but you did.
You know what I mean?
And they said some people feel choked.
Yeah.
Particularly men, but some people feel choked when they go in there and you're blue and you felt that.
I did.
Yeah. And you'll now believe in that.
Yeah. But yeah. Cause that's a red. It happened to me. If it happens to me, I believe it.
Yeah. So blue people, I feel like can take that and then they're like, oh my God, I don't know what that is, but I'm never going back there.
All right.
So,
I mean, I will not go back in that house. Yeah. I can't physically go back in that house.
Yeah.
I start choking.
Right.
So, all right. What about indigos?
So indigos, a lot of the blue stuff, so if they're less self-aware of their energy, they can take it in too and get sick. But with indigos, I think like more of it is the ability to feel oddness. Like, okay, something's wrong here. Something's magnetically off. There's some vibe here I don't understand. They're the ones that are able to feel more of like the magnetic fields, the vortexes, the portals, the energy. Kind of like that feeling when you know a hurricane's coming, you know, or you just like something's in the air.
Yeah.
There's a storm coming. I feel it. You know, I used to feel that living in Buffalo before a blizzard, and now I feel it before a hurricane down here. So it's just kind of like that something in the air. They can feel that shift a little bit better. Okay. Indigos. But, you know, they're still emotional and they're sensitive. They take on feelings. They have like a knowing, you know, but less likely to get sick, but it can still happen for indigos.
All right. What about my color, the reds?
So red auras, I notice, they don't readily believe it. Yes. And they want to see it and challenge it. We do.
I have this like need to, that's why I keep saying I want to go to West Virginia. I want to go to West Virginia because I want to see it. I want to see it for myself.
Red auras are funny because they're like, I don't believe it, but let's go.
Exactly.
Like that.
Yes, exactly.
Whereas
right.
like I think a green aura would be like shrug, unless it happened to them and they'd be like, okay, now I'm proving it like that. But red auras are kind of like, yeah, let's do it. It's almost like, They want to challenge it. Now, if a red aura does experience something, I feel like they want to double down on proving it to others.
Yeah.
So they want physical proof that it's real. They can be hard on their own selves to get that proof. And it's funny because reds would be, I would say, they don't care what other people think the most. Except when something like this happens, they care more than anyone else. So they need other people to believe them to be at peace in their own minds. And they can get very intense and obsessive about it.
Okay.
So I noticed like just on that Skinwalker Ranch thing, they had some veterans coming on that actually were pilots and saw UFOs. And they had them come to the ranch and it's funny because these guys, they started their own private business for getting, I guess, I don't know, good footage of these things. Like their whole life now is proving that they're not crazy.
Right, right.
But these were like the experiences that were the Tic Tac or something. They were reported by the government is like, yeah, something happened. We don't know what that is like that. And they saw it in the sky. So now their whole business is trying to prove it.
And they were red words.
Yeah. And their whole business is trying to prove it.
I mean, that's another thing. Like does the Skinwalker Ranch and all this stuff, do they try to make it into a business? Do they try to capitalize off
this? Are trying to
kind of exaggerate it.
Well, two things can be true.
And that's a red thing to do, right?
Well, yeah, but two things can be true. Things can be real and you can try to make money off of it.
Yeah, but then what happens when
it's like both things can happen.
But then the line blurs and then all of a sudden they start like maybe embellishing.
That's what happens.
And then it's not as like fantastical as you think it is.
We try to make the paranormal normal around here.
Yes.
It's honestly normal stuff that happens to us. These ghost stories, auras, psychic premonitions, all this stuff. This is actually normal. But out there in the world, it's been like fantasticized or whatever for entertainment value.
Yeah.
And that's just what happens. People are like, oh, that's not interesting enough. Make it cooler, you know? And then it's like, oh, then it gets silly.
Okay. Yeah. Well, the next one is actually
my pet peeve.
The next one is actually the color I'm most interested in.
Oh, yes.
And that's turquoise.
I feel like the turquoises, I feel like the poor little turquoises are the ones that get hit with this the most, I have to say. And this is why.
I can see that.
Yeah. Okay. So I feel like the paranormal, whatever that is, will communicate very visually with the turquoises, meaning they'll see it. They'll actually see it in ways that we're like, are you sure? Like that. Turquoises just accept the paranormal on such an absorbent level that they'll oftentimes, I feel, see and experience things that are just so weird, so otherworldly. People wouldn't believe them. And they know it. Turquoises already know it. So they keep it to themselves. And I mean, it's like kids with imaginary friends, but like adults. And they've lived their whole lives like this. So these are adults. I see turquoises as people that believe in the fairies and believe in the mermaids and believe in the, I guess they're called cryptids, by the way, like the Mothman and all this stuff. They believe in all Bigfoot. They believe in it readily, just because they have an open mind for the connections between the paranormal and the normal. And they're very fluid about what is real or not real according to what they're told. Because turquoises live their lives. So we talked a lot about turquoises being kind of invisible and living their lives so outside of the rest of us and kind of feeling like an afterthought a lot of times because they're so absorbent that they can also relate to things that are an afterthought or seen as invisible or kind of disregarded because they themselves feel disregarded. So I feel like a lot of paranormal things are attracted to turquoises because the paranormal is often ignored and brushed aside. And that's how turquoises feel. So,
right.
And they have more of an acceptance towards it.
And it's interesting because they probably have the believability factor that people are going to question them the most.
Yeah.
Right? You're going to question the turquoise the most.
Yeah.
If it's believable. You know, Abby's our turquoise. And we're always kind of questioning.
Like, really, Abby?
Is that true?
Yeah.
Is that your interpretation, Abby? Actually, I just saw that happen in front of me and it didn't happen that way. So,
yeah.
So, like, there is that questioning that you have with the turquoise.
Yeah.
At least I do.
Yeah, I think they're a little bit, they can just be different anyways because they're so used to being in their own world that it's hard for, but I also feel like if you believe it more, you see it more. It's kind of like a radio tune. And I've always felt this about these things. That's why I don't always like doing episodes about these things because I feel like it turns the attention of whatever we're talking about onto me.
So, okay.
And that kind of stresses me out a little bit.
Interesting. Well, that's what you were saying about indigos. Being like that.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. I put up my walls to this stuff. Like, when we walked in the Riddle house, like, I felt that bad energy, but I was like, oh, no, buddy. No.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I'm like, well, I talked about it, I'm sure, in that
episode. No, I know, but you have the ability that you can do that.
I can feel it enough to be like, okay, like that. Mm. Just like seeing a crazy person, like, no eye contact with you.
How come I couldn't do that? How come we just got...
Because you're so... You're 3D. You got the 3D boundaries. You don't got the 5D boundaries.
All right.
You have 3D boundaries. So somebody comes up to you, you have no problem saying F off, get out of here. No, like that.
Yeah.
But you have no 5D boundaries. Now I don't have 3D boundaries.
You have 5D boundaries.
But I've got good 5D boundaries. Yeah. Okay. So it's just opposite.
All right.
So anyway, that's the turquoises. Okay. And then, yeah. Oh, pinks.
All right, last one, pinks, yeah.
Honestly, pinks are, if anybody's going to befriend a ghost, it's a pink. I feel like, it's interesting, I just have to bring this up. There's this, I don't know her name, but she's on TikTok, and I know you may, she lives in Marilyn Monroe's old house.
Really?
Yeah, and she's a pink aura, and Marilyn Monroe was a pink aura.
They have conversations.
It's really interesting, like in the TikTok, she'll show, look what I found, like in the rafters, or just she'll find things around the house, and she feels like Marilyn is leaving them for her, or whatever. So my point being, even that little noise you just made, okay.
Does she wear Marilyn's old dresses?
She looks like Marilyn Monroe, like she dresses like her. It does what?
Wear her old dresses and ruin them sometimes.
What do you mean?
Wasn't that a whole big thing?
Oh, with Kim Kardashian? Yeah, oh, that's funny. She does dress like her. She looks like her and all that. But anyways, I feel like that's just my little story. Pinks will befriend a situation. Pinks, a lot like turquoises, are used to kind of being shoved away from society. So they're not so readily willing to do that to things that they hear about. So if a pink person hears like, there's a ghost in your house, they're like, really? Oh, okay. You know, instead of like, whatever.
They're going to play Barbies together.
Yeah. They're okay. Like, all right, cool. So they're going to be more like friendly towards it, or they have an open mind or energy towards it.
All right. Well, I mean, the goal here for me is I really want to believe this. I've never had any of this happen to me. I've never had a UFO experience. I've never had a Men in Black experience. I've never seen a Mothman or anything like that, or a Skinwalker. And so I'm just going on what other people say. So I want to, you know, I want to believe them. I'm going to believe people in the mystic Michaela spiritual family more than I would believe a guy like John Keel.
Right.
But I'm trying to figure out if there's an oracler that I can believe more. And that's what we're doing here today. So when we get back, we have a couple ads. We're going to go through listener stories that from the Mystic Michaela Spiritual Family page. We had, I think, hundreds of stories come in.
Yeah, they're crazy. They're really good.
Yeah, and what I also asked you to do was tell me the oracolors of the people that wrote in the story. So you did a little deep dive onto those people, looked at their oracolors, and I want to see if there's some sort of correlation here, if there's a more believable color than the other colors when we get back.
Now a word from our sponsor, BetterHelp. I sometimes need just to take breaks. I need to put my phone away. I need to get out a book that I have been wanting to read. I just need to spend time with myself. How well would you take care of your car if you had to keep the same one your entire life? Well, that's how our brains work. So why don't we treat them that way? I personally have learned from my BetterHelp counselor how to take care of my brain. And sometimes that's just taking time for myself and shutting down things that take me away from that. BetterHelp is online therapy that offers video, phone, and even live chat only therapy sessions, so you don't have to see anyone on camera if you don't want to. It's much more affordable than in-person therapy, and you can be matched with a therapist in under 48 hours. Our listeners get 10% off their first month at betterhelp.com/KYA. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/KYA. Hey, Cat Dad.
Hey, we have cats everywhere.
We do.
Right now, there's actually two cats in my lap as I'm taping this.
But let me tell you something. We see our cats. We don't smell our cats.
Very true.
Kitty Poo Club is the most convenient monthly litter box ever, and that's why we don't smell them every month. Kitty Poo Club delivers an affordable and recyclable litter box that's pre-filled with the litter of your choice. They even have an extra large litter box option for all those fluffier cats out there. When the month is up, you just recycle the used litter box, and Kitty Poo Club will automatically deliver a new one to you. You can easily customize your subscription at any time, too. Maybe add some toys or treats or accessories, whatever will make you and your kitty happy. And right now, Kitty Poo Club is offering an awesome discount on your first litter box order and free shipping when you set up an auto ship. Just go to www.kittypooclub.com to save on your first auto ship order of litter boxes with free shipping. And be sure to let them know that Know Your Aura with Mystic Michaela sent you after you check out. That's kittypooclub.com. Hey, Scotty.
Hey, guys. So as we're taping, if we go to the Facebook group, there are still people posting about experiences in West Virginia that they've had. And I just want to read the latest one to come through. This is from Carol Ann. She says, hello, Mystic Michaela Spiritual Family. I just wanted to thank Mystic Michaela for validating West Virginia is super sketchy. Laughing face. I went there 10 years ago with my husband for firearm school, and it just felt so off to me. I can't really describe the vibe, but I didn't like it. I felt all the people were, and they have like the alien emoji. It was just so creepy. I'm glad I'm not the only one. So it seems like a lot of people, and then there's a lot of comments underneath it saying the same thing.
It's crazy because it's gorgeous there.
It is. Yeah, the scenery
is
gorgeous.
It's beautiful. The people are very nice. You know, it's just weird.
Yeah. And it's so weird because now I'm even more drawn to the area.
You like want to go back.
What you were saying about Reds, they want to double down.
Yeah.
I want to double down.
You want to have an alien experience.
All right. So we did ask the Mystic Michaela Spiritual Family for their UFO sightings, their paranormal experiences. And I wanted to add the oracolor to it, just to get their oracles. You're going to tell us their oracolors. And just to see if there's some sort of correlation, if there's something that, you know, I'm really doing this for me to see if I could believe it more. You know, I really want to believe.
I don't know how you don't believe when you read that thread. I mean,
yeah,
if there is so much, I highly recommend if you just want ghost stories around the campfire, take out the thread and start reading it to people because it is some scary stuff from our totally normal people on the page. So here we go.
All right. So we're going to start with Anna D. I'm going to read this one because it's easy. The rest are harder to read. So
okay.
We'll give a deal. All right. I grew up on a farm and distinctly remember on multiple occasions seeing something walking around outside of our house and in the fields. And I just somehow knew it was aliens. This happened two or three times in my childhood. I was terrified to go outside alone at night.
Whew, I got chills.
All right, see, so I'm thinking it could be a bear at this point. Well, or something like that.
Anna's purple and turquoise.
Okay.
So she immediately just accepts what she knows and feels it is. She's got the purple, like her intuition is right there. Nobody had to tell her what it is. She just knew it. And she just accepts it. She just kind of absorbs into it. That's the turquoise thing, you know, and a lot of people wrote this, that they would, people that lived kind of in nature areas, they would see things and they felt it was aliens just automatically. That doesn't, it feels otherworldly, other creatures, like kind of shape-shifting, moving through nature.
Oh, okay. Now, again, my role here is to play the skeptic, right? Yeah. So, you know, Anna puts this in and I believe her, we could believe her, but also there's a part of me that says, well, all right, how do you know? I mean, you're saying it's this purple intuition thing, but I'm saying it could be a bear or I don't know.
Or just the leaves moving or the leaves whatever. Moving.
Sure, sure. Or something, anything. But she's really saying that she believes it was aliens, but she didn't see them, but a yet she still believes it.
It's interesting, though, for Anna, just a lot of people, this isn't an isolated phenomenon.
Right.
Like a lot of people say they see things shifting in the woods and taking other shapes and hiding there, and they feel like they're aliens.
Okay. Maybe it's just a purple thing.
It could be.
Who knows? All right. Next one we have is Leslie J.
All right. This gave me chills. She says, not me personally, but my grandpa, who is a high-ranking military man, worked at Area 51 for a time. He would never tell me what he did there other than aliens are real. He wasn't much of a jokester. Very serious and intimidated me a little bit, so I believe him. Leslie's yellow and blue.
Okay.
So for her, you know, just relationships, like she believes her grandpa and she understands her grandpa. So for her, that makes sense. Because for a guy like that to be like, listen, aliens are real. Like that's freaking scary. You know, he wasn't a jokester.
Right. But again, this is a two off account here. So, you know, Leslie's hearing this from her grandfather.
Yeah.
But she's believing her grandfather.
Yeah.
He's yellow. And why would he, you know, what reason does he have to make that up to her, I guess?
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to know what his colors were.
Yeah.
Maybe he's a red or something.
Well, he was like a military guy. He was you know, not a joking personality.
Right.
It gave me chills.
Yeah.
And then some other people wrote that kind of they had people who worked in those areas, too. They're like, can't talk about it like that. But with kind of the connotation like, what? Like, so there is something not to talk about? Kind of like that.
Right.
So,
and like, what does he have to gain? I'm trying to think. What does he have to gain by telling her that? You know, nothing.
Listen,
really,
like,
right?
Can you imagine knowing that aliens are real and you can't tell anybody?
Yeah.
Like, I'd get it out of you. But, like,
I'm spilling it right away, by the way.
You're spilling it right away.
Yeah, I'm spilling that right away.
Like, they're real. No, but, like, can you imagine? And then you've got, like, a little granddaughter and you want her to stay safe. And you're like, listen, you know, trust yourself. They're real.
Yeah. Because, Did she say what age she was when you told, right?
No.
Yeah, because, I mean, you wouldn't, like, want to scare a kid either.
No, but if I knew something weird was out there, I would tell my kids. And if my kids were like, it's stupid, it's da-da-da, I'd be like, listen, don't go to that area.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And if you were a red and they were talking, like, that it didn't happen.
Oh, yeah.
I'd be like, no, that happened. Okay.
I can assume he's either red or green because if he's a high-ranking military officer, those would be your colors. One of the two or both or something. And yeah.
Okay.
So.
All right. And Leslie, you said was yellow and blue.
Yeah.
Okay.
So she believes her grandpa, you know, and she's like, you know, neutral about it that way.
All right. Next we have Christina E.
All right. Are you reading it?
You could read it.
Okay. So this is cute. I like this one. Once my friend and I were driving through my neighborhood at night, we saw an animal running. So we stopped the car. When the animal got close, we realized it was huge and didn't look like any animal we've seen before. It stopped in front of our car and stood on back legs like a human and stared at us before it ran off again. We both looked at each other completely lost for words. It looked like a cross between a human and a dog or wolf. It was probably around 6 feet tall when it stood on its back legs. We always say it was the time we saw a werewolf. However, I've brought this story to others who have said it sounds like Dog Man.
Okay, well, if it happened in South Florida, it's definitely a regular person.
It's a local.
It's a local, yeah. It's a local. All right, what are Christina's colors?
She's pink. She's pink and blue.
Okay.
And I just, even the way she told the story, she's like so pink.
Yeah.
She's like, oh my God, I just saw a werewolf. Cool. Like other people, I think because she's pink, she's just like, that was so neat. And other people, they'd probably change their life or they'd freak out, or they'd be like really like some sort of trauma issue now or something. But she's pink, so she's like, oh, it's dog man. It's super dog man. Cool.
Yeah.
Well, saw werewolf, haha.
Yeah. That could be like the Skinwalker. That's what they were saying. They were seeing a dog type figure.
Yeah. Yes, they were.
Yeah, it was like there was someone like things that looked like dogs.
That was crazy because on the Skinwalker Ranch they have like dog tracks, but 3 feet apart.
I mean,
it's just kind of like a huge animal would have to make that track.
Yeah. I mean, I'd love to know where this happened, first of all.
I know. Yeah. And she's pink, so she didn't include her location.
Right. like, there's a lot of places where this could be a person. I mean, South Florida, definitely. And there's other places, you know. This could be me after I haven't shaved for a couple of weeks. So it's possible, Christina, you saw me. It's truly possible that I was the one.
Okay.
All right. So pink. All right. So, and what were colors you said? Pink.
She was pink and blue.
Pink and blue.
Okay. Yeah. She just made that like a fun story.
All right. Yeah. That's interesting.
Sounds scary.
All right. So we got Dogmen. We got Mothmen.
But now we're getting scary.
Okay.
This stuff freaks me out.
Now we're getting freaky.
Yeah. Now this stuff I don't really like talking about is so scary.
All right.
Are you reading this or am I?
No. I'll let you read it.
All right.
This is from Nicole A.
All right. Not so much aliens. More on the paranormal side. I posted a year ago about something being attached to me and all the things that have happened that I cannot explain. In that post, I talk about X's or sideways cross scratched into an ex-boyfriend's stomach and back. Well, fast forward to a couple months ago, I've now had the same thing scratched on me. And she has a picture of it. And the only reason why I thought this was interesting.
Well, I have the picture here.
Yeah.
And that is freaky.
It's really, and the only reason why I thought this was interesting, and I think she thinks it's more of like an angry ghost or something. And it could be, but it kind of aligns up with some other things I got on the page about alien abductions.
Okay. What are Nicole's colors?
Oh, she's like turquoise and purple and yellow.
So a tricolor.
She's a tricolor, but she's a lot of turquoise.
A lot of turquoise.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, and she's more turquoise purple with like a yellow kind of sparkle. And that yellow could be just without a huge deep dive brought on because she's purple turquoise and she needed something to like deal with life something.
Does this go away or is it still there today?
Well, this is what freaks me out because then we have Elizabeth K. wrote on the same thread. And she says throughout her life, she's always seen UFOs and aliens and ghosts and things. But she writes, when I was little, I was abducted. I still have what my mom said was a burn mark in my arm where two triangles are back to back. Interestingly enough, it kind of looks like hers is an X, but you could see it as triangles. And then she's saying they're triangles. She said, when I got them, I told her I was packing my bags and going to see the world. She asked how, and I pointed to the sky and said, with them. She wouldn't let me sleep by myself for a long time after that. And and just as other things kind of happened in her family and stuff that were very unexplained and odd. But the burn mark thing, and Elizabeth is turquoise and green.
So, okay, she's turquoise and green.
So these turquoises.
Yeah.
Finally, I had to bring up this, and she's not in the Mystic Michaela spiritual family, but
are you sure?
You may know her as the nanny, Fran Drescher. And if you look it up, she's been very vocal that she was abducted by an alien. And she says that she has a scar on her hand from the abduction.
Okay.
And it's a crazy story, but she believes it, and she tells everyone about it. She's not ashamed to talk about it.
So what are
and her, like, she says her husband was too, so and he has the same scar on the same part of his body on his hand too.
On his hand too.
Mm-hmm. So, and they were the same age when they got abducted.
So these like markings that they leave over to
Fran Drescher says it's where they put a chip in you.
The markings are where they put the chip
mm-hmm.
in. So Fran Drescher and her husband.
So Fran Drescher said that when she was like 12, she was driving in the car with her dad somewhere, and she got abducted. And she has a mark on her hand, and she remembers it. Now, her ex-husband, when he was 12, they didn't know each other, was driving in the car with his dad and got abducted. And he has a scar on his hand. But now,
isn't that okay? So that's, but that's where they put the chip in you?
That's where Fran said they put the chip in her.
So isn't that easy to tell? You just go to the doctor and say,
it's undetectable.
Oh.
That's what they say.
Okay, okay.
It's not able to be detected by anything modern or whatever.
Do you happen to know Fran Drescher's aura colors or no?
So she's very purple.
Purple.
Yeah. And then, I mean, she's kind of hard to read. Like, she's purple blue. Sometimes she's got pink in her a little bit, but I feel like she embodies so much of the nanny that that makes sense for her character and stuff, but she's very purple.
Okay.
That's like her big collar. Yeah. And she said that like, then they met not too long after her and her husband, they were together for a very long time. And, she feels like they were programmed to meet.
All right.
The husband does not say that's how he got the scar.
Okay. What does he say?
He said that it was just like an accident, but she said they programmed him to believe that. Okay. I just have to say that. Those freak me out. Like alien abduction stuff scares me.
Yeah.
Because I do believe in it.
I mean, if she could produce that chip, I'm all in.
But it's not detectable.
It's not detectable.
No. See, they're like ahead of us. You know what I mean?
So like they put in a chip.
They're a couple steps ahead of us. Yeah.
It's kind of like that artist who made the sculpture that was invisible.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So like he did a sculpture, but it wasn't there.
Right.
And he sold it for like $20,000.
Okay. Or something. Well, that's like the aliens.
Same kind of thing. Yeah. All right. All right. I mean, a little far-fetched, but okay.
Okay. So let's go to the next one.
All right. So the next one is from Kat L.
Mm-hmm.
She's actually in my the Wednesday night discussion group.
Oh.
And we had a fascinating discussion about this. All right. You want to read what she said?
Yeah. So she says, this isn't mine, but it's my husband's. When he was about 18 or so in the 90s, he was shooting hoops outside with his brother. His brother got a call from his girlfriend and she told him to look towards her direction. And they ran back outside and did. There was this huge craft slowly coming towards them and it was right above the lamppost. He said it made no noise at all, was completely silent. It was in the shape of a triangle. It went in the direction of Phoenix. After we were married for a few years, this show came on TV about the Phoenix lights. He got all excited and said, see, that's what we saw. I guess so many people in Phoenix saw them too. Wish I had. And this is actually a widely documented phenomena. And Scott, you looked into it. What'd you find out?
Yeah. So I looked into it and I guess according to the Mutual UFO Network, mm-hmm. Okay, on March 13th, 1997, between 7:30 PM and 10:30 PM, thousands of people reported seeing strange bright lights flying over Nevada, Arizona, and parts of Mexico. So basically, it wasn't just one event. There were many events across the state, happened over like a long period of time. And it was like this V-shaped object, the size of a commercial plane soaring, or
wow.
Even larger than that. Again, I don't know. We weren't sure. The governor came out with a statement. You know, he held a press conference about it. I looked up and he was kind of mocking it. He came out with like, I think an alien.
Yeah, somebody dressed up as an alien
or something.
He was joking.
Like that. But then he actually retracted his statements and said the opposite, that it could possibly be some, you know,
because he saw it himself.
He
that's
saw it himself.
Why.
Yeah, he saw it himself.
So, and then he was like, never mind, it's true.
Yeah. And then there's actually pictures of it. There's actually little video of it. I don't know. I mean, to me, it looks like these lights that are all lined up in a triangle formation.
Yeah.
I mean, could it be something else? I don't know. I mean, I'm not a believer on that one so much. What did you think? What was Kat's color? But do we do Kat's color?
Oh, yeah. She's like green and turquoise and purple.
A little green. Blue and turquoise. Okay.
Yeah. Green, blue, turquoise.
Yeah.
But her boyfriend saw it, though. But
yeah, that's true.
Yeah. But I feel like when people see something like that, they intrinsically know. Like, if you saw it, you'd be like, something happened or something's up. And, you know, the governor's reaction and something like that. And there was never an explanation for the aircraft. There was never an I think they tried to have an – I think the government said something about the lights. But
– yeah, I mean –
there was never an explanation for that aircraft. And the whole thing got moved silently. And it was so huge. And it looked so different. And so many people saw it. What was that about? You know?
Yeah. I mean, obviously they saw something.
Yeah.
I mean, it's obviously there's actually footage of it. You can see the picture of it. It's this V-shaped formation larger than, you know, a commercial aircraft. But I mean, can it be one of 100 things? I don't know.
A government thing they don't want to tell us
about government thing
something.
They don't want to tell us
why
about.
Would they just drive it over? Why would they like fly it over residential areas, you know, and rile people up? I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, I'll even say like one thing the other day, I was actually just driving, it was daylight, and I saw this huge flash of light, like this burst of light.
You did?
Yeah. And I was like, what is that? You know, it was the middle of the day, too. driving on Boynton Beach Boulevard, and it's just this huge flash of light. And I didn't know what it was for a sec, like for a few seconds. But then I realized it was a massive group of pigeons that saw just the way it reflected in the sky.
Okay.
It gave off this I thought something exploded in the sky.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Actually, I didn't tell you this.
That's cool.
It just came back to me. And like at first I'm like, what was that? Like, that's freaky. But then it was like this group of, I saw these pigeons flying by. So like, I mean, I don't know.
But it was moving so slow and people took pictures of it.
No, I know. I'm just saying like it could be, there's like 100 explanations
or something.
Yeah,
but there aren't any. So right now it's an unidentified flying object.
That's true.
And it's just weird.
Yeah.
So it's just kind of a cool phenomenon. And there's so many of these unexplained things.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, I think this is our
last one. And
Julie.
Let's see what you think about this one.
Okay.
Julie Ann writes, it was about 10 years ago midnight. I find myself looking out the bathroom window, which faces the front yard. I am waiting for my daughter to get home from a date. Yes, I am one of those mothers who found it hard to fall asleep until she was at home. I think I'm going to be like that too. As I'm gazing out the window, I see to the left a gorgeous blue gaseous ball of light. This is a blue unlike any blue I've ever seen, a shade that to this day I don't believe I've ever seen since or before. This ball of light was not round, but oblong, maybe 7 to 8 inches across. As I watched it sail through my yard, my brain could not comprehend what I was seeing. A falling star, perhaps? No, I knew it wasn't that. It sailed through my yard and then started to make its way up the window I was looking out of. I was in awe and could not believe my eyes. As it approached the window, it slowed down as if it were looking at me as much as I was looking at it. It then left the window, went down the walkway, past the driveway, crossed the street, and went between two houses across the street from me. I was shocked and tried to grapple with what I just witnessed. Less than 5 minutes later, my daughter comes home. I run out to her to meet her in the garage and tell her everything that I just witnessed. We decided to go looking for this gorgeous ball of light. So we went across the street but saw nothing. We came back to our front yard and looked around but continued to see nothing. Whatever it was, it had simply vanished out of sight, never to be seen again. Interestingly enough, this is what she writes. I live in an area where back in 1959, in the hills above my home, a partial nuclear meltdown took place. It had mostly gone under the radar at that time. Very few people lived in this area. And many people have claimed to witness strange aircraft up in that area to this day.
Okay. And what is Julie Ann's
called? Oh, she's very purple. She just had a tiny little profile picture and I couldn't stalk her further. Okay. But she's very purple.
Very purple.
She believes herself, for sure. She knows it was something.
And you said it was near a nuclear...
It was near a nuclear meltdown site, and a lot of people do see interesting lights around there, and I think UAP, unidentified, what is it called? Aerial something, something. Like light projections in the air. Yeah.
Well, I mean, that also does seem to be a commonality.
Yeah.
Around nuclear power plants or... some sort of plants or manufacturing business factory type atmosphere. Same thing with Point Pleasant, the ammunition factory. So I don't see. That's why I always go back to maybe it's just the government doing weird undercover things that they just don't want to get out, or maybe they're just trying to, like in West Virginia, maybe they're just trying to clean up the land that they've destroyed. There's a lot of cases in West Virginia. We talked about this last week, where they've destroyed the land and. The land is, hazardous, and maybe they're just trying to clean it up. I don't know. I mean, I don't know.
I mean,
so for her case here again, maybe it's the government doing things,
or she
saw this UFO,
or maybe it's this UFO's attracted to those sites for some reason.
Right.
There's been documented reports released from I think even the government itself that they've seen UFOs around where they were making nuclear weapons, disarming nuclear weapons, things like that. Yeah. So
do you think there'll ever be a point in time, like let's say it's 5 years from now or whatever, where we'll all just agree on it? We'll know with certainty, with 99.999% certainty that, okay, these UFOs that we've been seeing since the dawn of time, basically, are real.
I think that if... it doesn't pose an immediate threat, they're not going to tell us. So if they know things we have, and it's just not enough information, I think we'd all lose our minds. It might even cause a total disruption in our society. And if if it's not so much of a danger or an issue or anything that they wouldn't want that to happen, they're not going to. But it seems like they're easing us into information, which makes me, this is my intuition talking with the UFOs and stuff like that, because I believe that there's some sort of communication, intelligent communication. And I feel like it might be picking up a bit, and they know it's going to continue to pick up. So they got to ease us into it. They can't deny it 100%. They got to ease. Oh yeah, we see it too. Mm-hmm. You know, like that. Cause they know it's going to, I feel like they know it's going to get even more and more prevalent. So they're easing us into it.
Okay. I mean, it was huge in the '60s, and that's, we're talking over 50 years ago.
So many people on the thread too were saying that they saw things in the '60s.
Yeah. So I mean, you're talking about 50 years. That's pretty slowly easing us into it.
Well, that's our timeline because we're humans.
Do you think there'll ever be like an Independence Day, the movie moment?
God, I hope not.
Where just all of a sudden there's like I think that's what it's going to take for me. For that, and I hope that doesn't happen, by the way. But for me, it's going to have to be like this aircraft that comes into our atmosphere. We all see it.
Yeah.
And then like little Martians come out.
Oh, great. There's a lot of people that feel like they're keeping an eye on us to make sure we don't destroy ourselves. So.
Yeah. Well, that's.
Which, you know.
That's a tough task.
Yes. Good luck.
Good luck with that one. All right.
Well.
Very interesting. And it's interesting. A lot of the color, just to kind of summarize it or recap it, seems like a lot of purple, a lot of turquoise here.
Yeah.
When you were going through, because I know you went through all the stories. We went through all the stories. And again, I think that there is a commonality there with that, the turquoise purple.
Yes.
Yeah.
It seems to be that's the.
It doesn't seem too many reds were.
Chiming in
well, on
that. Yeah, it depends on your personality, like, you know, which is part your aura colors, your energy vibe or whatever, like where you brushing it off. Not, yeah, you know,
or maybe they just didn't, first of all, we don't have any reds in the group.
We don't have a ton of reds in the group.
Yeah, then maybe they didn't want to.
Yeah, or they're not like sharing it a whole lot because they don't want to.
Okay.
Like you don't go around telling all your experiences to people.
Right. Yeah. Like that one with the flying birds the other day. I didn't tell you until now.
All right. Well, thanks for hanging out with us the past two episodes for our supernatural sidebar. We absolutely loved talking about this. It's so fascinating, and I definitely want to do it again in the future. Thank you so much for spending some time with us today. You know this podcast is for you and about you, and you all take care.